And I brought one out.
What do you mean thrown in?
The ATF threw in grenades in their dynamic entry.
No, they didn't throw any grenades in, as I understand it.
Yes, they did. I brought one out.
They were flashbacks. They did not
explode. Have you ever seen what a flashbang can do to somebody? It's a grenade. It has an explosive charge in it. It's very dangerous. It can blow your hand off. It can blow your face off. It can kill. I would have brought out some of the unexpended grenades that the ATF threw in, but I was worried about bringing out a live grenade, so I left them there. There were a number of grenades.
Okay, Mr. DeGaren, I think that would hamper your credibility because you're the first person who would say that those were grenades. I've never really sat through a hearing the way the likes of yesterday. 6.5 hours of defense lawyers, their marathons, their ways of sliding over the truth was very unfortunate. This idea of the FBI having hand grenades, not flashbangs, but hand grenades. And finally, coup de grace, Mr. DeGaren said flashbangers can kill, injure, maim. Anyone who knows anything about these things knows they can't.
Mr. Kavanaugh, I have in my hand here a amount of Play-Doh. Mr. Bush, if you could, this is just standard Play-Doh. If that were a flashbang grenade or a stun grenade, the same thing, which was live, which pin had been pulled, would you feel comfortable just holding that in your hand?
Well, Mr. Barr, a flashbang grenade, my answer is no. I would not want to hold it.
Those are classified as destructive devices under 26 U.S.C. Section 5845F, aren't they?
Yes, sir, they are.
That they can kill people, is that true?
Certainly, yes, sir.
Well, a gentleman by the name of Warren L. Parker, an explosives enforcement officer, Bureau of ATF, on May 11, 1994, in court, said under oath that they are designed to help kill the suspect while not endangering the law enforcement officer when they're used for those purposes.
I'd like to focus on the search warrant. First, it was put together, as a number of witnesses have testified, in a prejudicial and
feasible manner with excessive force. And the law is clear. Even an arrest by lawfully constituted officers can be resisted if, before anything else happens, those officers use excessive force.
They of a couple of agents or a couple of detectives walking up to somebody's front door or knocking on a door in three-piece suits to execute a warrant of any kind is over. And that's where we stand. We stand between the Koreshes of the world and everybody here. We stand. Law enforcement.
First 15, 20 minutes, it was get the job done, shoot the video. And then when you see people getting shot, you can hear people screaming and the bullets hitting. I have two daughters.